Well, what a difference a week has made. In 4 days, the supporters of the rightfully elected, internationally recognized president managed to take over a huge chunk of the country. They now control 80% of the country. It happened because a lot of the military and police support for President Gbagbo, the incumbent who refuses to step down, just switched sides. So they were able to reach the commercial capital, Abidjan, where there's fierce fighting and looting. People are just hunkering down. But the most disturbing news came yesterday when the International Committee of the Red Cross said that they had seen 800 bodies in a town in the west called Dwekwe. And the UN today came up and said that they have seen 330 people killed there, both mercenaries and civilians, and they blamed that massacre mostly on the supporters of the internationally recognized president.
Are there details, like people were, you know, rustled from their homes, people were in some common area, and that's why they were targeted? What's the story behind that?
It's still very murky. They're still trying to find
a clear story.
They say both sides were involved, and they also say that this is retaliation from the Ouattara, the internationally recognized president's forces who are allied with him, that this was retaliation. And they're warning that the tension is so high that the country is could really go into an orgy like this
just
of retaliation. So they're saying if this comes to a head where Ouattara, it looks like he is going to finally be able to assume the presidency if Gbagbo falls, which looks like he might, because he only has a few loyalists who are left with him. The military has left him. His army chief fled to South Africa. So it's a very dicey situation. Like last weekend, we were talking about the country being on the brink of civil war. 1 million people from Abidjan have fled.
The longer this takes, possibly the more volatile and possibly the more violence. Ralitsa, thanks so much. Appreciate it.